clubs were also hit hard with lost business during the last 30 hours or so. But tonight, just a couple of blocks of Sunset Boulevard are still closed off around that repair site. But even that will likely change soon. Saturday night on the Sunset Strip with a few snags. More than 30 hours after a massive water main burst along Sunset Boulevard, traffic is picking up again. We're talking about wheels and feet. Although the journey to this nightlife hotspot can be a little more challenging.
I had to walk from Fairfax to here. Was like between 15 minutes, 20 minutes or so.
At the peak of the problem, Sunset was completely closed for several blocks. The Mondrian Hotel had to cancel a party with 800 guests. And the Comedy Store heard more crickets than laughs Friday night with a dismal crowd. This is all part of the fallout from a massive water main break along Sunset Boulevard Friday afternoon. The rupture in a nearly 100-year-old, 3-foot-wide steel pipe sent water gushing in all directions down the Sunset Strip and down side streets in neighborhoods to the south. West Hollywood looked more like a system of small rivers at the height of the disaster, with the broken line spewing an estimated 9,600 gallons of water every single minute. Tonight, the pipe has been patched, welded, and the whole surrounding it filled with slurry, a mix of dirt and concrete.
No, I can't say that this was typical. This was on a 36-inch main, and we do not get very many leaks on that size of pipe.
And back here live, the House of Blues actually closed its doors last night. No one could get here, but tonight the place is open for business. Fans are jamming inside, and there's a good crowd in there. I was there just a short time ago. Well, the plan is to have all eastbound lanes of Sunset Boulevard and one westbound lane open by midnight, and it looks like they're going to be on schedule. For now, reporting live in West Hollywood, I'm Chris Wolf. Tia, back
to you. Quite a while.
Hi, thank you for that.
As fire naturally kind of cleans up after itself.
Well, more rain is expected over the King Fire burn area this evening. Hopefully by tomorrow, that'll be good news. That'll help firefighters with more containment on the ground.
All right, Nicole, thank you for that. And as Nicole mentioned, rain has helped firefighters get a handle on the King Fire. But with that rain comes a new concern, possible contamination of the water supply. Forestry managers are concerned because any rain that falls in the fire zone will flow into rivers that feed reservoirs like Folsom Lake. That muddy runoff is full of soil and possible contaminants, which could overwhelm sanitation facilities. That's on top of another potential problem, mudslides from future rains. The region recovering from some wild weather tonight. Overnight rain pelted the valley, while the Sierra got a fresh coating of snow. And Dennis, a lot of people asking us, is there more on the way?
We're not done with the system just yet. It was a decent rainmaker, at least for this early in the season. And as you take a look at the radar, you can see the center of circulation has moved off into Nevada, but what we're getting now is what we call the wraparound moisture. It is heading from north to south, and then it'll take a turn south of us back to the east. So, as we take a look at what we have already received as far as rain from this system, you see those amounts. Now, this is focusing on the I-80 and the US 50 corridors, anywhere from a quarter of an inch to 3/4 of an inch of rain from just this one system over the past couple of days. So a good start, and yes, it did also bring some snow. This comes to us from North Star just this morning. The chairs were set up for a wedding this afternoon, and a lot of that snow did melt in the afternoon. But again, it is a good start. We will talk more about where this rain is going next and how long we'll be dealing with it coming up in a few minutes, Tia.
All right, thanks for that, Dennis. A community in Napa cleaning up after last night's rare hail storm. The fast-moving thunderstorm brought strong rain and hail the size of marbles, catching people in Napa completely off guard.
It was a really phenomenal storm, you know.